sounds like gun first. Will you go first?
Welcome, everybody. I'd like to call council to order, please. And if we could start with a moment of self-reflection. Thank you. Thank you. Could I ask council for any pecuniary interest in each thereof, direct or indirect, please? We'll now go into camera. Right, and if we could go to the committee room, please. Okay. No, Member to seconder. Councillor Andrews.
No, I get it.
Second by. Thank you, everybody. I'd like to proceed with a couple of things to say. We are currently in open session, having come from a closed session. Right? The items listed under the closed session, which was personal matters about identifiable individual, including municipal or local board employees, section 239(2)(b). And with that, before we go to the consent agenda, we'd like to announce we have had a little bit of a problem at the Jack Burger complex, and it is currently closed. And I'll just turn it over to our fire chief to comment on the situation.
Thank you, through the mayor. At 5:30 tonight, Port Hope Fire responded to the Jack Burger Sports Complex with respect to a fire in one of the dressing rooms at that location. Fire department did respond, and fortunately there were working sprinklers at the location to hold the fire and confine it until we arrived. The fire has since been extinguished and we're in stages of overhaul. There are no injuries reported, and the complex will remain closed through tonight until the investigation is complete.
Thank you very much. Unfortunately, these things do happen, but I think we're under control and there's no injuries and no problem. So we'll update you as required. I think that our communication manager, Kate, has also put some notification on our website, or is doing it as we sit here, one of the two. Thank you. Before we go into the consent agenda, I think we have a couple of things that have come up that we'd like to acknowledge. And to do that, I'm going to go up to the podium. So bear with me. Taking advantage of a couple of things that we'd like to comment on, and so kind of before we jump right into the council agenda, we're going to do a check presentation to one of our 2019 community grant recipients. Float Your Fanny Down the Ganny is run by a group of dedicated volunteers with an aim to execute a safe and challenging river challenge. Host of interactive festivals that acts as tourism and economic driver for the municipality of Port Hope during the spring season, and if people remember, we were, I think, categorized in the top 100 in Canada. In 2018, the event attracted over 10,000 spectators based on the estimates of the emergency response teams along the river. Among these were spectators of all ages, from seniors to infants, many of whom were from out of town. And we're looking forward to the annual race again this year. And so is council. I think we've had some discussions that we're going to get a little more involved. So Barry, keep us on track here. Okay. So we are looking to the race again this year. So mark your calendars for April the 13th and put you in your order for good weather that weekend. The rain date is scheduled for April the 20th. And with that, I would like to bring Barry and anybody you want to bring with you. These folks are the recipient of the grant in the amount of $30,000. And we'd like to come up and present that to you. Thank you.
Was not a rain date, it was an ice date, because we'll go in rain, but we won't go in the ice, Bob, because we can't get down the river, and we appreciate the support the town has given us, the councillor has given us, and the citizens give us, so we're looking forward to having a great day.
Thank you and your team very much. I also want to, you know, really encourage volunteers.
Yes.
We can't have enough volunteers, so the more volunteers we can get out, the better, even if it's only on the day.
Right.
Everybody knows how to get over the barrier.
That's right. The website.
The next thing I have, and it's a privilege, though, is to do a little presentation. And tonight we would like to make a special presentation to Mr. Ken Andrus, who is retired from the municipality on November the 30th, 2018, as our chief building office official. Ken started working as a building inspector 29 years ago. He worked as a licensed carpenter prior to joining the municipality, and during his tenure, he has continually upgraded his technical skills on the building code and property standards. And throughout his career, Ken shared his technical skills and others through his training of the building inspectors who were hired by the municipality of Port Hope, but also through his own training in other municipal employees and trade professionals. Ken has led several certification courses for the Ontario Building Officials Association, which is OBOA, and the Ontario Association of Property Standards Officers, OAPSA. Everybody has acronyms, right? Over the years, and was member of the executive for the OBA board for 14 years, which was 1999 to 2013. On November the 6th, Ken celebrated his 25th year anniversary as our chief building official with the municipality. And throughout his tenure, he has addressed many after-hours calls and provided exceptional service to the residents and building organizations in our community. Not here, but also everywhere. Ken plans to continue teaching in his retirement and will continue to share his knowledge with others in the profession. And that aside, Ken is looking forward to traveling with his wife, Glenda, and spending more time with his family. And Ken, come on up, and we wish you the very best. And we can't explain you enough how valuable you've been over the years, right? It's probably one of the toughest jobs. I don't know if anybody ever thanks you, but I do. Thank you. And with that, this is a very small token of our appreciation.
Councils and present. and the staff that I have worked with over the last 29 years has been absolutely incredible. The work, the dedication that the staff from this municipality put in, the hours they put in, and the cooperation throughout the departments has just been tremendous. And I couldn't have asked for a better place to work, to have a career, and really enjoy myself. And I can honestly say I never, ever got up in the morning and said, I don't want to go to work today, because every day brought new challenges. And I thoroughly enjoyed myself. And I want to thank all the staff. Again, the present staff and past. It's just been wonderful. Thank you.
Thank you very much, not just for the service, but you know, all the help that you have provided, both to the staff and to council. I know I availed myself of it quite a few times, so I again appreciate very much and enjoy what you're doing, but don't disappear in the woodwork just yet. Thank you. So with that, we'll get back to our regular agenda. And as many of you know, I do like to do some good news stories, but I'm going to wait until the end of council to provide you with some of that activity, and that way we'll move on to the consent agenda. We have 3.1 and 3.2. Either of those, does anybody on council need to pull those out for any further discussion? Not seeing any. 3.1, Council Meeting Minutes of January 15, 2019. And 3.2, Committee of the Whole Meeting Minutes of January 15, 2019. Could I have a mover and a second to accept those, please? Moved by Councillor Mink and second by Councillor Bickle. Any further discussion? All in favor? Would be carried. Is there any business from the previous minutes or any notification of new business? We don't have any petitions or delegations for council, and we don't have correspondence, which means I'll move on to staff and committee reports. 7.1, Daphne Livingston, Legislative Services Manager and Deputy Clerk, regarding the Sculthorpe-Willacott Lane Agreement, and to repeal and replace bylaws 14-2018 and 67-2018, and recommend that we refer this to bylaws. Could I have a mover and a seconder, please? Deputy Mayor. Second by Councillor Mink. Any discussions? All in favor? Carried. 7.2, Amanda Hassan, Financial and Planning Coordinator regarding Ministry of Transportation. This is the dedicated gas tax funding. Again, recommend referring to bylaws. Could I have a mover or seconder, please? Moved by Councillor Carr and second by Councillor Lee. Any discussion? All those in favor? Carried. 7.3, David Baxter, Director of Finance, regarding repeal Debbie Sherwood as Deputy Treasurer. Recommend again refer to bylaws. Could I have a mover and a seconder, please? Moved by Deputy Mayor. Second by Councillor Meadows. Any discussion? All those in favor? That would be carried. 8.1, 8.2, and 8.3. Does anything have to be removed from this list for any council? Seeing then, 8.1, recommendation from Corporate Services, January 15, 2019, Advisory Committee Review. 8.2, recommendation from the in-camera, January 15, 2019, Local Board Committee Appointment. Center of Action for Environmental Sustainability Working Group. 8.3, recommendation from in-camera, January 15, 2019, begin for a local board and committee appointment, Parks, Recreation, and Culture Committee. Can I have a mover and a seconder, please? Moved by Deputy Mayor, seconded by Councilor Meadows. Any discussion on any of those? All in favor? That would be carried. And then I'm going to go to the bylaws. Moved by Councilor Mink and seconded by Deputy Mayor Andrews. Now therefore be resolved that bylaw 05-2019 being a bylaw to appoint members to the Port Hope Public Library Board be read a first and second time. Any discussion? All in favor? That would be carried. Moved by Councilor Lees, seconded by Councilor Carr. Now therefore be resolved that bylaw 06-2019 being a bylaw to repeal and replace bylaw 14-2018 to clarify the land use descriptions for the road allowance stopped up and closed on municipal land for the purposes of transfer be read a first and second time. Any discussion? All in favor? Carried. Moved by Councillor Carr and seconded by Councillor Lees. Now therefore be resolved that bylaw 07-2019 being a bylaw to repeal and replace bylaw 67-2018 being a bylaw to stop up and close the municipal road allowance and clarify the legal description of the subject lands be read a first and second time. Any other discussion? All in favor? Carried. Moved by Deputy Mayor Andrews and seconded by Councillor Meadows. Now therefore be resolved that bylaw 08-2019 being a bylaw to enter into a letter agreement between the Corporation of the Municipality of Port Hope and Her Majesty the Queen in right of the Province of Ontario, represented by the Minister of Transportation for the Province of Ontario, relating to the funding provided by the Province of Ontario to the municipality under the dedicated gas tax funds for the public transportation program be ready first and second time. Any discussion? In favor? Carried. Moved by Councillor Mink, seconded by Deputy Mayor Andrews. Now therefore it be resolved that bylaw 09-2019 being a bylaw to repeal bylaw 38-2014 being a bylaw to appoint Debbie Sherwood as Acting Deputy Treasurer for Municipality of Port Hope be read a first and second time. Any discussion? All in favor? Carried. Moved by Councillor Meadows and seconded by Councillor Lees. Now therefore be resolved that bylaws 05-2019, 06-2019, 07-2019, 08-2019, and 09-2019 be read a third time, pass and the said bylaw be signed by the mayor and the clerk, sealed with the seal of the corporation and engrossed in the bylaw book. All in favor? Carried. I think this is a good time to get into some of the community updates. Lots going on. Certainly, from a safety perspective, we do our fire safety, but at this point of time, we'd like to maybe expand on that, and we welcome any tips from the public regarding safety as well. I have some notes here about the winter, any precautions we should take, but I think right now I'm going to overlap that and comment on the Ganarasca River and the associated creeks around here. If you've noticed, some of them are running pretty high. So from our safety perspective, we'd like the people to stay away, particularly if you have children. It can be very attractive to children, but we don't want to lose any. So take a look at the flooding. It's very unusual that it occurs at this time of year, but it does pose a significant safety hazard. So thank you for considering that. And the Municipality of Port Hope has launched the operation of the new municipal transit buses effective Monday, February the 4th. And the bus schedule and locations remain the same. And please take note of the new buses. And they don't have their logos on yet, but they're wonderful devices, and we look forward to getting them looking as they are part of the municipality. Do you know when that's going to happen, Jeanette, the logos? Oh, did it happen this afternoon? Okay, it already happened, guys. We have also officially begun our strategic planning processes. Last week, we completed 4 successful consultations, 2 for the community and 2 for staff. And for those who were not able to attend in-person consultations, you may submit your feedback through our community consultation process. And for details, please visit porthope.ca/community-consultation. Written submissions will be accepted until February the 28th. I'll add a little bit to that in that we will have an expanded process. We certainly expect to get some increased rural input, and then we'll have discussions through that period of time. So through till 28th, be active. I've got to commend staff and the facilitators that we've had. The feedback that I've had regarding the sessions and the input have been excellent. So thanks for everybody who is participating, and particularly to our staff who is facilitating it all. You still have till 28, so if you want to see this community looking good for the next 4 years, you better step up. Port Hope and Sunrise Rotary Foundation held their awards dinner in November. And I'd like to very seriously congratulate our own Councillor Jeff Lees, George Kalanakis, Stella Pitcher, Amy Tedford, Allison Houston. They are all recipients of the Paul Harris Award from Rotary International. This is a significant award and acknowledges individuals who contribute or have contributed money in their name of $1,000 or more to Rotary Foundation, Rotary International, but mostly who have contributed extensively to our community. And Councillor Lees, you know, you're to be commended on all the work you've done, and congratulations on that award. Well earned. And Port Hope residents Art and Donna Marvin have been recognized as Green Leaders by Forest Ontario. They've planted more than 11,000 trees on their property over the past 2 years. This was through their efforts as part of the province's 50 million tree program. However, to date, the Marvins have planted approximately 20,000 trees. I don't think we're going to be able to stop them. They're on the go. And a reminder to everybody to nominate an outstanding volunteer. Actually, I'm going to leave that one for Officer Meadows. I think she has something to say on that. Okay. And I invite everybody, I think we were up here today, but I invite everybody to join in support of the coldest night of the year in Port Hope on February the 23rd. The goal is to raise $50,000. By walking and fundraising, you support people in our community who need your help. And for more information, please visit www.cnoy.org. I think there's a lot of people in the community to participate. This should not be something that isn't rather evident and is supported. And I think we all pitched in a little bit tonight. Unfortunately, council can't walk. We do have an appreciation dinner that we have for some of our staff. Otherwise, we'd be walking warmly in the cold. I turn over to councillors who would like to make any comment about our community events. We can start with you, Councillor Meadows.
Thank you. This year is the 31st annual ceremony of the Civic Awards Program, and it will be held April 25th at the Cameco Capital Arts Centre. The program has recognized more than 2,300 people since its inception in 1987, and it is now open for nominations. So everyone is invited to acknowledge outstanding achievements and contributions to our community by submitting a nomination. This nomination program is designed to highlight the variety of elements that make up Port Hope's inspiring culture by recognizing those who contribute time, talent, and resources towards improving the quality of life in Port Hope. There are 9 award categories: Outstanding Citizen, Outstanding Youth, Agriculture, Arts and Culture, Athletics, Community Service, Inspiration, Philanthropy, and Environment. I encourage you to take a look at your network, make a submission if you notice someone who meets the criteria in any of these categories. You can get more information about the Civic Awards program. Eligibility and award category criteria is also available online at www.porthope.ca/civic-awards. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor. Does anybody else want to bring anything up? Certainly a comment on the Civic Awards. It's important to participate and to nominate. It takes a little bit of an effort to do a good nomination, but if you think of the small effort in doing that compared to the large effort people are putting into the community, it's a very small consideration to recognize. So thank you, Counselor, again. Couple things on the county update. Good news. Council approved the 2019 county budget with an amendment to reduce the base levy increase from 2.5, which was proposed, to 2%. Council reviewed options to reduce the levy by 0.5 percentage point, and we agreed to eliminate the bulky waste voucher program to achieve this modified target. Vouchers that were scheduled to be mailed out before the end of January 2019 will no longer be distributed. Final budget documents are available on the county website at northumberlandcounty.ca/budget2019. And just a little comment on that. The county has tried to keep in pace with the rest of the communities within the county, and I think most of us have really tightened down. The nice thing about this, I go to give county staff a lot of credit. They were aware that we would like to see a reduction, and they did go through an extensive amount of work to determine what would have the least impact on the community. And removing the bulk waste vouchers, we felt was significant, and it lowered by 0.5% the levy, which is actually to the taxpayer, without impinging anybody's ability to go and take bulky waste. The program, I believe, cost about $30,000, but this saves $268,000. And I know that some of us all get vouchers. I can never find mine. And if I need to take something, it becomes now a user fee rather than something that's automatic on your taxes. So we were quite excited about that, actually. And Northumberland County is offering tree samplings at no charge to county residents through the Emerald Ash Borer Replacement Tree Program. It's a 5-year program subsidized by the county. It's available to all residents in Northumberland. Each residence may order between 10 to 500 trees to plant on private property. All 2019 orders are due by March 31st. And again, for more information about the program, please visit the GRCA website. The Eastern Ontario Wardens Caucus, very interesting, says that it's staying on the course in 2019. The number one priority for this year will be improvement and enhancement of cellular mobile broadband networks. The Eastern Ontario Wardens Caucus held its annual conference last month. They've been talking to both levels of government and continue to work with the Eastern Ontario Regional Network, EORN, on its business case. And the business case would close the cellular network gaps and boost mobility broadband service across the region and increase public safety for residents. And just to expand on that a little bit, it's probably the highest priority that we heard in the last little while. It's been on the discussion plate for about 2 years, with, in our opinion, not a lot happening. But I can tell you that the priority has increased. Perhaps a newly elected government, and one that wants to be elected, has made a little bit of a difference, because they are all at the table looking at this as a priority. So I'm really looking forward to having some action and a little less talk on this. And we'll keep you advised. But I think between this and housing strategies, these are the high priorities that I'm seeing. So that's the county update. Are there any questions from council? Press?
Could you repeat the date of the Civic Awards presentation, please?
The deadline for nominations is March 7th, and the ceremony itself will be held Thursday, April 25th at the Campbellfield Cabell Arts Centre.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Any questions of the public? So if we're good, we'll adjourn, and we'll resume the Committee of the Whole meeting in about 5 minutes. Thank you.